to go with that culture.
Right. When you are children, there used to be a game of cooking. So the person do the cooking and food. Yeah. Everything is concept only, but it appears so real game like that. So with that understanding, how is your life changed? Life changed?
Yeah, acceptance. Whatever is coming, let it come.
Okay. So has it mind become peaceful?
Yeah.
Huh?
It's not that
bad.
My
awareness now, I can question my awareness.
You question
our
awareness?
Whenever I'm aware, I'm aware. This last month there was an incident, and I could realize, even though I used to think that I'm aware, when I'm talking and I'm responding, I'm aware. What are my like? Some of the things we would have just accepted, and some of the things we may say, okay, that's the way it is, and that's why we may say I don't have attachment. But the real like, there are some more things that I'm still attached. That opened up in the last 1 month, and there was a lot of duality that why is it so much attached to me?
Okay. So?
Yeah, acceptance, and it's improving my patience level.
So my patience level means whose patience
level?
Whose
patience level?
Who is that mine?
My thoughts. The thoughts that...
There's nothing called my. It's an appearance in consciousness. The moment you say my, you are another create another contrary, boundary.
I can understand.
Now you understand. See, how many flavors are there for I? Okay, go ahead.
It's just the ego that is getting hurt. I am not touched
by it. Good. Smita?
The middle class
are
acceptance is the main this one. I had started that, and now I understood what is the meaning of exactly accepting the things, because I had lots of disturbances in last 1 month. I myself was surprised that I was able to handle it. I was able to handle that, and awareness has...
Who is I was able to handle? Who is it? I have a lot of disturbance.
That is what was understood. So
tell me, what is that understanding?
So I'm not the body, mind, intellect concept. So I keep on telling myself that I'm not the body, mind concept. So even those disturbances, although it was a little bit more of a serious nature, I was able to accept it and handle it.
Very good.
When we say I, you again question. So it's a little difficult.
See, that question it.
You can talk in third person.
The questioning is because I don't understand when you say I. When you say this mobile phone, I understand. When you say I, there are millions of possible types. I's are there. Which I you're referring is not clear.
So though we, at least,
we
understanding, no, I am going to say just, I here, the unreal I, seem to have understood the concept of I am not the body, you know. But day-to-day life and the way you did, that has definitely improved. And when there is a conflict of interest or views and, instead of holding on to my ideas or my views, I'm now able to give it another thought or another view that, this is not going to be there. I mean, this is not real. So, I mean, if we are all, here just players, then why bother about it, sort of. So, I mean, slowly getting into that mold of handling life.
Yeah.
So, that's really helped. Thanks. And when doing some work, or you know, when suddenly thoughts are coming, a lot of thoughts, you know, I'm able to, you know, stop them and just focus on that what? Moment, on that moment, saying okay. So that way I can avoid those thoughts, and even though I don't sit for, you know, hours or minutes to meditate, by focusing on that moment, I'm able to do,
very good.
Be attentive to that.
So right now you are becoming aware of thoughts coming.
Yes.
So earlier you are getting lost in the thoughts.
Yes.
So that's the difference. So one who is aware of the thoughts is Atma. So now you are able to distinguish?
Yeah.
Okay. Separate out what is noise and what is real.
Yes.
Yeah. So now we are able to... able to realize sometimes whenever thoughts are coming, oh, this is not required. So stop at that. Okay, and then concentrate. As
see, earlier the thoughts were coming and you are getting unconsciously identified with that.
Yes.
See, that's exactly happens in a dream. Okay, in dream what will happen? Suddenly a thought comes, I'm in a flight. You will not even question. Okay?
Yeah.
You just think that I am in a flight. Okay, there's a fire. You don't know, you don't think that it's a thought. It's a fire is there. So you're identifying the thought, and when they identify the thought becomes real. Okay? So as long as you understand the unreality of thought, you'll become free from it.
Holding on to the right.
Okay, very good.
Something, help me.
Something is who?
That I don't know.
Is there something, somebody?
No.
Is there some ghost or something which will tell you? Like
we are attached to body, mind and mind.
Who is we?
I.
Who is I?
I just body was attached to emotion. Body problem and intellect in the past. But now, even though all are there, I am aware of that.
That is a separation happening. That's good. Okay. This separation is called mukti. Gradually it will separate out. False from the real. Okay. Kateni? That's it.
Just being aware of that. Many times whenever there is any situation, the body looks like it's in the present moment all the time.
Mm. Body is in present moment, yeah.
So that's something which is observed all the time.
Okay.
And any type of meditation, it's more like steps for the final sakshi. That's
see. See how careful she is. She has not used the word I, we, or me. She has spoken in third person. I was watching to catch her that I thought. That's all. Okay.
Comparing it with my last experience, I am not that much doing, I mean that awareness was that much. I was more involved in the work and other things for some reason. So my another thought came that, okay, I should do much better and all. So I felt like that, okay, who wants to do that? But I have, there is a very firm feeling that there is a firm spirituality, there is some final realization which I need to achieve it by doing more meditation, more understanding, more reading. But this is all happening in that background. So definitely I am that background. But there is an infinite loop where I am that, okay, I feel that there is a background. Okay, I am that background. That itself is a thought. Behind that also some background will be there. So what is that background? When I try to express it, it is all spoiled. Just be silent. I think deep sleep is the best way. Whenever some thought comes about, okay, this is my I am self. This is what I am. It is like it is all totally false. Breaks down. I don't know how to.
Okay, today I'll teach you how.
Things are happening. Many things are happening.
Okay.
Instead of reactive, responsive type.
Okay.
And playing the role given to me.
Very good. Given to you by whom?
Given. Playing the role.
Who gave the role to you?
Consciously trying to handle things. Very balanced. Very balanced.
Very good. So you try to avoid a controversial eye.
I don't think I'm succeeding at all. So this trap is always there. So we go empowered after every class. We'll be listening to videos and recordings and all that. So you always said, right, sir, you always said, you know, we should always remember the Paramatma or the deeper entity, right? So with that we start, right? But when the stress or the work or the comes up, then that is all thrown out of the window. And it becomes completely the devil or the protagonist becomes so.
Yeah.
So I think I'm failing, I would say, honestly.
No problem. Sudha?
Summary of almost what everybody said in the class is what I experienced.
So, tell me, what is it you experienced?
That in the last 1 month, I have gone through a lot. Physically, I was very ill. But again, at all times, that separation, I was aware of the separation. That though I know myself as the body and the mind and the intellect, and I am every second living as the mind, body and intellect, I am not this. I am something else, I am the deeper consciousness. I have no clue what it is. I have my blown experience. But just reminding myself that
So how many eyes are there?
I am very conscious of two eyes.
Which?
She's very clear.
Throughout the day, I'm conscious of that thing that I think of myself as this body, mind, and intellect. But I am not the sun, something
else. Something else I don't know. You will never know, also.
Never know.
Okay? Something else you will never be able to know. That something else is real you. And what is this? Is an instrument.
Of that.
He is having lot of fun.
Okay, well,
yeah. All our experience, he is laughing. Yeah.
Actually, so far he used to come and sit and listen to my class. Now he is sitting here to learn how I laugh.
From the first class, we started from here and then reaching there.
Where?
From where we started.
Where we started?
About I. So again we are coming to back to
I. Yeah, that's only I.
Yeah, no.
At the I, what you call as yourself, you'll never know. You cannot know. Because eyes can see anything, but eyes cannot see itself. You are the seer. The seer cannot see itself. Seer cannot know itself. Seer can know everything else. In the process of knowing everything else, it gets confused.
You say so, Prakash, man. That is...
No, I am saying...
It doesn't require anything to know itself. It knows itself.
No. It knows itself
knowing
not
is
as an object.
Nature, no?
Knowing itself is not an object. Knowing is being. It can't know how big I am, how small I am, how infinite I am. Because then it becomes an object. I exist is the knowledge. Now... That you try to define that existence, it becomes a knowing, knowledge.
When we try to express it, it is thought, through thoughts only we can able to express it. I mean, to ourselves itself, like, okay, I know. Then I know means that is a thought itself. So, that means I am not that, who is knowing that I know.
Okay, let me go into next understanding, okay? this here. Anyway, with this life is becoming better or worse?
It's improving.
Interesting.
Definitely improving.
Improving.
Guruji, you did ask for whom?
This actually, there is no whom anywhere. Okay. Finally, gradually, when you say realize, when Buddha realized, then he realized that there is no individuals. The concept of individuality is a concept only, no reality. In a wave, ocean, are there individual waves? It's one ocean is there. Okay? There are no individuals at all. That's actually is nirvana, final realization. There never was an individual.
Nobody.
Nobody.
Then how to know that realization?
No. There is a realization.
Buddha, how? Who know that? Buddha,
that's what I'm saying.
Buddha knew that.
He no. That's what I'm saying. You are saying, for whom? There's no for whom. That's a realization.
But how Buddha was able to say that, now I have realized?
So for Buddha is saying, you are saying Buddha's body speaks, you are saying Buddha is speaking. Buddha's body is instrument, mobile phone.
Okay.
Who is speaking through mobile phone? Nobody.
Nobody.
Awareness.
Speaks means speech is coming from somebody.
It's always speech is coming from nobody. Okay, but you are associating an identity with that.
Who identifies
him? Nobody.
Nobody identifies him.
In your dream, you became a billionaire. Who became a billionaire?
I think I was a billionaire.
You think you are a billionaire, but were you the one who made were a billionaire?
No.
Same thing.
But who was that? Who thinks it's a billionaire? Because consciousness can't think.
You tell me with a sweet dream. What is happening in dream is happening now also.
No, I am dreaming is a actually wave.
I am dreaming is a wave. That's all.
So only thoughts are coming and going. There is nobody to identify. Now who identifies that I am that thought?
Nobody.
Who is that nobody?
You see, I'll give you in river there's a whirlpool. Right? You have seen the river whirlpool?
Yes,
sir. So you put some paper into that whirlpool, it will go deep inside. Now, who created the whirlpool? Who is that whirlpool?
Is something, but I am talking about subjective thing that why that feeling of I comes? What is that I? The identification, not I, identification.
See, this is what I am saying.
Consciousness can't identify, and thought is just coming away.
See,
can't identify.
Again and again, you are getting into a dream like in dream situation. You are saying, why the dream tiger came? Why the dream elephant came? Okay, that answer can be, dream answer can be given. So here only teaching is given how to wake up from the dream. After waking from them, they are become irrelevant. There are million questions you can answer in the question in the dream. Why the light is there? Why sun is there? All answers are dream answers. None of them will help you to get out of the dream. What is required to get out of the dream? Understand. Then after getting out of the dream, why you bother about dream?
Get out of the dream is to lose the identification.
Yeah, I'm just teaching method to how to get out of the dream, right? Okay, let's define the problem, okay? Thank you. you have thousands of thoughts or millions of thoughts. All of us have a lot of thoughts, right? Thought. God thought, I thought, everything. Okay? Now, is this the way we started our life? What were, how many thoughts were there as a child for you? How many thoughts?
Probably
the child is simple. You see your child, right?
Momentary thoughts for children, right?
Young children. Young children. Where are the thoughts?
No thoughts.
Right? Isn't it? But as you grow up, your mind is filled with the thoughts. Right? Yes or no?
Yes.
So, as a child, the life was simple, no complexities. Mind is free. That's why the children are very sharp. Okay? They look at something, they notice something which you can't notice. But your mind is now so cluttered, you are not able to notice anything, even say something is in front of you. Right? What happened to you from child to adult?
Many concepts. Because a child, when it sees something, he doesn't know that it is a dog or what it is. He just sees it as something. But we know that, okay, it is a dog, it is having four legs and everything. Our mind is cluttered with concepts. That's what
I mean. Right? So many concepts are filled in your head. Yes or no? The child's life is simple. We become more complex. The whole process of realization is, can I become like a child?
Okay.
That's all. These thoughts are there, these concepts are there, fine. Can I live my life like a child? And that is called Jivanmukti.
That is called?
Jivanmukti, liberation. So Buddha is like a child. Ramana Maharshi is like a child. Okay? So, some between the child and adulthood, somewhere something is spoilt. Right? If you look at here, love is a thought. Okay? Father, mother, God is also a bigger thought. Everything is a thought. Thought is a concept. Okay? Are you clear? And where did the thought come from? Where did the thought come from? Where is your thought coming from?
Either from memory or from consciousness.
Memory.
Mind.
Ultimately it's consciousness, but we'll call it as memory right now. So memory, that's equal to past. Right? Memory is always related to past. Do you agree?
Yes.
Okay? Memory is related to past. Yes or no?
Yes.
So then, imagination is equal to future. Equal to future. Imagination is the future, memory is the past. Understand? Is it clear? What happened to the present?
It's nowhere.
What happened to the present?
We are not trained to be the present.
What happened to your present? He's absent.
Memory, imagination, all is in present only.
No, it is. Memory is the moment you think of the past, okay? You are gone to. You are missing the present. What is your present is what you are experiencing right now. Experiencing directly.
Yeah, I am experiencing my past.
Yes. So it is the past is coming and the present experience is gone. The current experience.
But that past in that memory that is coming in this present.
Okay. I mean, let us have a cup of coffee, all of us. Let him drink a cup of coffee from the past.
Not possible.
Huh?
Not
possible. Why?
I can think myself of the past.
Yeah.
The present.
No. It's but not real.
It's not. No, but that thought is real, which is coming in the present.
Drink a cup of coffee from past.
Past I can't drink.
That's not exactly what I'm saying. So what is not real, you know it's not real. The cup of coffee, imagine, is not past or the past is not real. That's why you can't drink a cup of coffee. Right? But what happens is you miss the present cup of coffee in the thoughts of the past. The real you are missing with respect to unreal. Drinking a cup of coffee, nice coffee, then you start thinking, oh, coffee was so nice in Coorg.
The thought and the coffee, both are coming in the present. The only thing is that in the present, when the coffee is present, I am not. The thought is absent. When thought is present, the coffee is absent. That is
No. So the what is unreal is covering the real in the present.
The here real means what is in the present, because this is also temporary only. That coffee also.
It is available to you in the present. That is missing. Are you clear? Yes or no? Anybody has a doubt about this? So how big is your present moment in life?
Very small.
Huh?
Usually very small.
Very small. Right?
Actually, it has to be everything.
It is actually, it has become nothing. Okay, so this I can show you your reals, your current situation here is like this.
Can I say that I am always in now the present, but I am not aware always. I am not always aware of that.
If you are not aware, it's not there, not there.
I am always there.
You are always there, then if you are always there,
that I am in present.
That's what I'm saying. If you are not aware of something, it's not there for you. That's what is the point. Okay. So this is the situation today. How big this is the past. Present equal to absent. Because of what? Thoughts. Right? If you have no thoughts, present is only there. Correct? Because of thoughts, present is absent. Thoughts are not real. A cup of coffee, thought of a cup of coffee and real coffee, there is a very difference. Right? So, for example, a thought of coffee is not real copy.
You say that the world is a thought only, everything appears
as a thought. See, can if you experience the world without thought, the world is not a thought, world is Brahman.
But the objects, like coffee is like, it's coffee like the cup or taste and everything.
Mm-hmm.
That is an object, we are objectifying that. That is a thought. It's a bit
no, mind. That's what I'm saying. We'll come to that. If you are able to experience the world like a child, for this child, the world is God, Brahman. Okay. For you, the world has become thought. A child is really experiencing God. Okay, that's why we call child as God only.
Okay.
Child is really God. Not because of some, it's not a nomenclature. The child has no thought. When there's no thought, there's no separation. When there's no separation, you are one with the universe.
For a child, can you distinguish between this statue and the person?
The distinction, okay, is different from separation.
Because child
the,
for child.
The five fingers are distinct. The five fingers are not separate.
Separation means it is same as. I mean, it doesn't mean that I am separate and this is separate. This is what you mean to say. Separation.
So, right now, the child has a distinction, but there is no separation.
The distinction between what? You are telling
me? Objects.
Between objects. It can distinct, but it can't. It is separate.
A child, there's no separation.
What did you mean separation?
I am separate from this, the feeling is not there. Okay, we'll come to that. Huh? So, right now the present is very small point which we miss. Right? Agreed or not agreed?
Yes.
When you are fully involved in the work which you love, then what happens to the present? Present expands. Okay. If you don't like something, the present shrinks.
Mm.
Yes, sir? When you are involved in, let's say, art or painting or anything which you like, don't have sense of time. The present expands.
We are only aware of that painting only. Like other things, what is going on, we are not aware of. So we are another way, aren't we narrowing down our awareness to that picture only,
no,
that
no.
Work only?
That we also goes when you do that. I am speaking of situation, the we goes. We are speaking of we after coming back after from the painting. Right?
So only painting is happening. And nobody
yes.
There to know you also.
Hmm? Yeah, where is there somebody? So this is actually what is called Mani. Okay. This is a state of realized person or a child. Both mean same thing. Which now?
No. Because here what it says that the time is traveling from this now.
Is this mean this one?
This is
yes. Okay, that's fine.
Now is at the center and time is revolving around.
There's no time actually. Okay, so there's a Buddha picture sticking there, okay?
Buddha.
Huh?
Pendulum
is Buddha.
reminding us that it's no.
Right? So now, this is a state of a child or state of a jnani. Both are same. They are not different.
Children do not have, they do not identify like you know, when we, who are you, they might just give their
who name. Spoiled the child in you, tell me.
Yeah.
Growing up means being spoiled or something, huh? What happened to your child? This is the state. If you have a concept of a Buddha or Jivan Mukta, this is what Jivan Mukta. Okay, no thoughts. Right. So can you become like this?
Thoughts are there, we can't be there. When you are saying child, you know, because we don't know if child is thinking or not.
You tell me, out of million thoughts, how many thoughts are useful thoughts?
Everything is useless.
You are asking me, how can I live without thoughts? I am saying live with useful thoughts. How many of them are?
Not living, because of thought only, I feel that I am here. That's the problem. Even deep sleep person will never say that, yeah, I am there.
See, you are again confusing expression with the existence. Somebody doesn't say I am there, does it mean he doesn't exist?
No, he exists. No. So he's
existing.
Say I am not there, he has to be there.
Again, when you say I am not there, that's the expression. Why are you confusing expression with the existence?
For expressing thoughts is only a way to express itself.
For expressing, there is a thought, one thought. But how many million thoughts are there in your head which are useless?
Yes, sir. It is all useless. But one thought is useful. That I thought is useful to know that I am there.
That is to the extent what is required. Now I am saying you are carrying a garbage in your head. Okay? There may be apple also in the garbage. But you are carrying a garbage can and going around. And trying to eat the apple. Every time you eat garbage.
No, that is not true. I feel that I am that garbage. That is... to take garbage pan, this is not a problem. To think that I am that garbage pan. Because without thoughts or without concepts, we can't live it. To know that I am that concept, that I am that body, I am that mind. That is where identification is the problem.
See, the body is required, your vehicle, car is required, but you don't become the car.
Yes.
Now, the body has become you. Vehicle has become you. That's the problem. Vehicle is useful. Nobody says not useful. But how can you become, vehicle become you? That's what you tell me.
Either I should...
Sometimes we say my thoughts. Like, you are different from your thoughts, but in reality, in experience, you are the thought. I am the thought.
Either I should say...
So that's why if my thoughts are happy, I'm happy. If they are depressing, then I become depressed. So that identification is so strong. It's just that in words we say, I have thoughts, but there is no I in thoughts. It's just one in actual experience all the time.
But you are not that. You are the observer of that.
Yeah, so that is the practice that we have to do.
That's the practice I'm teaching you today.
Yeah.
Right?
So when you say I am the observer, then again this comes that, then there is that I who is observing everything.
Arey Baba, that's what I'm saying. That itself, the observed also disappears. How observed disappears is the question.
Okay, we will take sir like I is disappeared. This is the main thing, no sir, that identification, without identification, I can never know that I am there.
Without identification, you have to identify with your car to become and go to some place.
No.
You have to know this is a car and go.
But I am there to drive that car, I should know.
That is for that for moment you have to become a driver. Okay, you don't become a car driver.
No, I am not a driver also. But to know that...
No, I am an observer. For a moment you have to become a driver or a passenger to go in the car. But you don't have to become a car to do that. Identification to the body is not required to live your beautiful life beautifully.
But when I drive, I will be very careful that I shouldn't get hurt. Car shouldn't get hurt. Because I know that car is hurt, I am hurt. So,
but
anyway,
that's fair enough. Car. But the question is, do you have to become car to think, car to drive?
No, not.
You can drive car. Nobody drives the car carelessly, right?
But I have to be a present, but no?
You have to be present, I agree. Okay. But do you have to become car? You are saying your body identification is required for me.
No, body identification is not required.
That's what I am trying to tell you.
Not now, required,
but you are unnecessarily becoming identified with the body and causing problem. That is the whole point.
Because I am continuously seeing this body, you know, sir. That is why I...
You are not seeing the body, that is the point. We will come to that. Why you are not seeing the body?
Because the more we spend time with that...
She understood. Explain.
You are identifying with the body, so you are not able to see that this is only a body. It is only an instrument that you are using to live your life.
See, right now, okay, what's happening to you is, I'll show you what I mean when you are not seeing the body. Okay, did you understand, Kathin, what I said?
I'm not able to know the explanation.
Body. I'll just show you what I mean, okay? See, why the problem is coming, I'll just tell you.
More we spend time with something, more we become identified with that thing.
No. They are not showing good picture. Okay, I just wanted to show you some picture where you can understand what I am trying to say. Okay. So let us say, I become the body, okay, when I am attracted, my attention is on the external image. Is that clear to everybody?
I identify
with the body when my external image is. I identify with the body. With the body when my attention is on external image. Is it clear on to everybody? Kathyani? See, I have put the glasses and everything looks beautiful. Then I have forgotten that I am wearing the glasses. Glasses become part of myself. Are you clear? Yes or no? Isn't it? Yes or no? So, I mean, it's like a movie, no? 3D movie you are watching, you forget that we are wearing the glasses. Right? So, when you say, I am identified with the body, you are identified with the body because you are watching through the body, getting attracted with the world, I'll say you have never observed the body. So, start observing body, mind, intellect to become free. Free from identification. Is that clear? Yes or no?
There's no space between B and C.
What is it? So, you say, I am body, because you are using the body so to see the world, you are not seeing the body. The moment you see the body is not you.
Object.
Understood or not?
Becomes an object.
Huh?
An object.
I understand, but it will become like it is my body. That will be.
It's not your body. When you observe your body.
I am not the body, but it is my body. Because it is appearing continuously.
No, if it is my body,
glass, but it is my glass.
If it is my body,
yes.
Then you can't identify, observe the body. What is me, you cannot observe.
What is me, I can't observe. What is mine, I can observe.
No, mine is also a concept. Okay? So, are you able to observe? You know that there is a concept called my body, right? Is that not an object?
It's object.
That concept is also a thought, which
I
is not you.
Mind, that itself is an object.
That's not a thought. This is a thought. That thought is an object. They're observing the mind now. Yes or no? Okay. There is body. Are you not able to understand, or are you able to? What you didn't understand?
The logic that you explained.
Tell me what you didn't understand. No, then I can explain.
You're saying the body is not mine. I mean, there are two things. My body and this object belongs to me. So you're saying even the object belongs to me is not mine.
The object belongs to me is a thought. Yes or no?
I don't worry about your mind or anything. I worry that this thought is coming to this mind.
No, I'm saying.
So it's only the thing that whatever I am interested in, that I'm concerned with. So it's my property, something like that.
Correct. I am able to, whatever you call as mine, if it appears in front of you, then it's an object. Appears in front of your consciousness, called object. Thought appears to you. Thought disappears from you. Your problem is not thought appearing, disappearing. Your problem is getting involved with the thought. Yes or no? So, that getting involved is an addiction. How to get involved, get out of that is when you are able to observe, oh, this is my body, thought is coming. Right? The moment you recognize that this is my body, thought is an object appearing, then you are free from the thought. So, this is my body is also me, then you are involved in the thought. Are you understanding separation?
Yes.
Okay. Say, I am beautiful is a thought. Okay. So then you understand it is a thought, then you are not attached to the thought. The moment you say, I am beautiful is me, then you are with the thought. Are you able to understand? No, she has not understood. Okay.
You are saying when the thought that the body is mine, that is the attachment.
No, I am not saying that is attachment. A body is mine is a thought. Is that, do you agree on this much? And thought, okay, the moment I take the thought as real, then I am involved in the thought. Is that real? Understood? The moment I take thought as real, I am involved in the thought. So that actually all of us know. For example, give me water. The water is a name. Okay? The water thought, give me water, will not satisfy my thirst. Why? The word water is not water. The word called water is not really water. Huh? Right? What is water pointing to?
Taste.
So, when I say water, don't get hung on the words. Water is a pointer to what?
Actual.
Something real.
Actual experience.
Right? So you have to give me real water, not water word. Word will not satisfy me. Is this clear? So whatever comes in our mind is nothing but a pure word. There's not, this only pointing to the reality. Is this clear to you?
Sir, what I understand.
No, don't. Okay. Let me complete.
I understand this actually. What you're telling, I understand.
The mind is nothing but whatever I speak, express. It's only a word.
Correct.
Word is always a pointer. Word is not the object.
Yeah, correct.
Is that clear?
Yes.
Is this clear to everybody?
Yeah.
Okay. So when I, for example, I say flower. Is the flower, the word flower, flower is real flower? Water is a word, correct? So always a name is pointing into an object, correct? Is this clear to you, all of you? Now if I start thinking the word object as real, the word as real, then I am living in illusion. Is this clear?
No, here real means not the temporary, permanent. No?
No, yes, real means
actual experience.
See, people don't know what is temporary permanent real. I call you as donkey. The donkey becomes reality to you and you start cursing me. Your heart burns. Okay? The word donkey, is it donkey? Donkey?
It's a name.
Kathy, are you listening? Okay, stop that. So, what? You got something else, sir? So, word donkey, I call you as donkey. It's a word. Has it got anything to do with the reality? You are a donkey, I'll say. Okay? So now it becomes real for you. Your mind gets disturbed. Your mind gets agitated. The world, which is not, world is just a pointer, it is causing disturbance in you. Is this clear? Should it cause disturbance?
No.
Huh?
No.
Should it cause disturbance?
No.
Your life gets disturbed. But, yeah. By somebody says you donkey, okay, you get disturbed. Should you get disturbed? Why you should not get disturbed?
It's not
real. Because it is not real.
It is just a pointer. Okay. Right? Why are you smiling?
Because you are not a donkey. You're telling it's a pointer.
Okay. All your disturbance in life is because you take some thought and start taking it, making it real and get involved in that. Forgetting that thought is just a memory. It's just a name given, label given. They're getting lost. Right? The moment it's a thought only, you'll just get out of it. Is this much clear? Huh? So, I was so happy when I was a child. Is it real? Huh?
It's a past, right? Memory.
It's a thought.
Thought, yes.
Right?
Yes.
So if you are so, but you start feeling your heart, I mean the body starts becoming good, you start feeling a good hormone. Yes or no? Huh? A unreal thing started causing a real experience,
yes,
in you. Okay, let us do an experiment. All of you have eaten tamarind, right?
Yeah.
Tamarind. So now open your mouth and think you are chewing tamarind in your mouth. Imagine. Huh? Okay. So what happened to you? What happened to the mouth?
Sour taste. Now that sour taste.
An imaginary thing called tamarind created a real experience in the body. Yes or no? Does it? Yes or no? Why did it cause?
Memory.
Why did it cause?
World is labeled like that.
Because your brain is a computer, doesn't know what is imaginary, what is real. Okay? You should know what is imaginary or real. Brain doesn't know. Brain is a computer. You feed it a real thing or imaginary thing, it will take it as real and causes change in your body. Understand? You should know how to use the computer. The computer doesn't know. So computer, whatever you are feeding, the computer will take real or imaginary as real. For it is only one input. So if tamarind is put in the mouth, it says it should, juice has to be produced. It will produce the juice. Right? But you are the one who knows this is imaginary tamarind. It's a memory. I'm putting it here. You should know. Okay? Up to that much is fine. That's why you know the you're not chewing the tamarind now. Because you know it's imaginary. But what about your memories, childhood memories, past memories? You're taking them, feeding the computer again and again, getting the experience.
Yes.
You understand?
I do.
Huh? You do that, right?
Experience it does.
Huh. Now who should know it's imaginary? Does the computer should know or you should know?
I should know.
Huh? And brain is a computer. It is just recreating the environment. CD player, you put a CD, the CD player will do, play. So brain, you take a imagination, memory and put it to the right, you'll start playing, nice experience. Then you get into a nice experience, as if you are actually that experience. So now are you living in the real world or imaginary world now?
Imaginary.
And a person who lives in the imaginary world, what is he called?
Food.
What is he called?
Mad.
But you are giving medicine to other people. You are not taking medicine. You understand? Actually, those people who are taking medicine, they are fortunate. They know that they have a problem. They know that they have a problem. They are imaginary problem. They say they are taking medicine. But you are living in an imaginary world without taking medicine. You have a bigger problem. A person who has a cancer taking a treatment for cancer is a problem. Or a person who has a treatment doesn't know that it's a cancer is a problem. Are you understanding separation between the imaginary and real? All thoughts are imaginary. Okay? Because they are coming from the past.
Or future.
Future is imagination. Past is data. Okay, I mean, if past one cup of coffee is present coffee, don't drink coffee at all. You had one nice coffee at when you're 10-year-old, you keep drinking it every day. That you understand about coffee. But your memories, what nice memories with your friend, that's real to you. What an enemy of that, Maya, what kind of enemy is that? That is real to you. It's not real. If that is real, then I say don't drink a cup of coffee. One coffee you drink, one purchase one good coffee, drink it and every time remember it and enjoy it. Are you doing that? You're not doing that. But your memories, enemies, friends, you can again and again put back and says, I am that. You start going through emotions. The brain is a computer, it has no problem at all. It'll take whatever data you feed, it'll take that. You feed the data through sense organs, it'll give the experience. You feed the data from memory, it will give the same experience. The person who is feeding should know, no? Is this much clear to all of you?
Yes.
Okay. Right? Is this very clear?
Yes.
Sir, this part is not clear, that when you say, I am not the body, okay. When you say that it's not my body.
I am coming to that. First, you should understand the distinction, the imaginary or the past memory and imagination, and the who creates the experience for you is the brain. Okay, brain is a computer, it doesn't know what is real, what is data, what is, it can take the data from here, it can data, but the person who is feeding the data is you.